Seagrasses are being lost all over the world and in Florida, and they're being lost for a lot of reasons. The primary reason is too many nutrients in the water. So if there's too many nutrients, then algae can take up those nutrients and they can grow faster than seagrasses do, so they shade seagrasses, limit the light, and seagrasses die. Seagrasses are important both ecologically and economically in Florida. They act as a food source and a habitat for many commercially and recreationally important fishes and invertebrates. They keep the water column clear. They also change the chemistry of the water. They remove nitrogen, which prevents things like algal blooms. Once seagrasses are gone, it's really hard to get them reestablished. So it's important that we monitor them, but there's not enough people to monitor all of the shorelines, all of the seagrasses we have. And that's where Florida Sea Grant and Eyes on Seagrass comes in. We're using volunteers to fill in the areas where other agencies aren't able to monitor seagrasses. Today we're in Crystal River, specifically at Sandy Hook Island. We're here with some Florida Sea Grant agents who have established seagrass monitoring programs and some who are interested in starting new ones. We're here sharing best practices to work with volunteers and monitor seagrasses effectively. So what we're doing here is we're estimating how much of the seafloor is covered by seagrasses, how much is covered by algae. We're using rulers to measure the height of the plants. While we're down there, we're noting what animals are around too. If we're seeing scallops, if we're seeing other impacts to seagrasses like propeller scars.
We have two different programs that have really come together to form the foundation of Eyes on Seagrass. We started in Charlotte County, and then there was a group in the Panhandle that was doing some seagrass monitoring.
We see a need to kind of take what's going on in Southwest Florida and Northwest Panhandle and connect it together to have a statewide program.
And now we have the Indian River Lagoon is coming on board, and we also have Sarasota Bay, and then hopefully even more expansion up here in the Big Bend region. One of the biggest successes of Eyes on Seagrass has been the fact that the methods and the data were both used in the response to Piney Point, which was a natural disaster where a phosphate mine leaked a bunch of nutrients into Tampa Bay. Knowing that they already had Eyes on Seagrass protocols ready to go allowed different organizations to see how this ecosystem responded.
One of the things we've noticed, at least anecdotally in our project from our volunteers, has been the increase, or in their opinion, the increase in spread of grasses in the bay.
If you're interested in joining Eyes on Seagrass, reach out to your local Sea Grant Extension agent. They can tell you more about the program that's happening locally and when they might need volunteers and what they're looking for the volunteer requirements.